Last time, a bunch of idiots looked at a bunch of hallways and then got scared. And then from there, they went to, they went and found a really cool vehicle and decided that it's their new best friend. And then they decided to go mess up a big, big spider.
That's the worst recap that didn't cross any of the actual facts.
I'm in pain. You're the one who picked me.
I demote you. Jolt. Yeah. Can you do better?
Yeah, I think so. So, like Top had said, we found ourselves a Humvee. After going over some of our intel again, we discovered that we needed to go back to the village. The Humvee was, of course, from the garage at the... we drove it to the nearest subtram station that we could find. And I believe it was Triage's idea to just drive through the subtram in the Hummer.
And you guys found bees. And,
Sorry?
You found bees.
We found some bees.
Yeah, we found bees. They messed up our windshield a bit, but we're okay.
Which reminds me, the vehicle itself...
has a little damage.
And since you guys are about to enter into combat, I just want to pull up that vehicle stat. This is the AM General Hummer. As you guys know, this is the surprise round, as you have pulled up on this familiar scene a couple of spiders the size of dogs turn to face you.
So fight or flight, guys.
Well, this is where we need to get off. So
pull the trigger.
Fight.
Yep.
Okay.
Let's fight.
So let's go ahead. You guys have a surprise round action. Triage, you have initiative for the surprise round.
Sweet.
Let me see if I can.
Oh, son of a bitch.
Huh. Yep. That's a bummer.
God damn. Change your dice color.
Here's the thing, though. I mean, it's because of the your unfamiliarity with the weapon. It jammed up on you, apparently. But it's nothing that's going to... Yeah, you know, nothing that's going to... Yeah, in that missed action, you're basically racking it to fix it, to clear.
Can I still take a move action?
Are you leaving the vehicle?
No.
What type of move action are you planning on?
I'm going to release... the 50 cal and pull out my
I see what carbine. You're doing. Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, switching to my M4. That's my move action.
Okay.
All right. Fair enough.
Gamble.
Gamble's going to stand up a little bit in his seat to lean over the windshield.
Now, real quick, I need to put you guys on the map.
Oh, yeah.
In a way.
Mm-hmm.
In a thing.
Ah, thank you.
Okay.
All right.
So. I'm going to lock the tokens for a little bit here and see if that changes. You guys remember how to do the locked token movement?
No.
You draw a line to the location you'd like to go to if you end up moving.
Oh, yeah.
And I confirm it. It shouldn't be any different than really just moving. It's just slightly. But the benefit is that the Humvee should not move. Okay. So, Mr. Gamble.
Okay. Gamble's going to stand up a little bit in his seat to get over the windshield and take the gyrojet and point it at Mr. Spider 8 and fire.
Nice. With the sound of a sneeze, the gyrojet gains speed and rockets into your target. Go ahead and roll damage.
Insert sneeze sound effect here.
Is the gyrojet only a 2d6?
Apparently.
It's not like an explosive incendiary thing or anything like that. It's just what it is.
Typical rifle's 2d8.
It's not about the rifle. It's about the size of the cartridge.
That's true.
So
yeah, I think this is designed to be more accurate than it is damaging.
Yeah, again, real life we don't use gyrojets. They weren't that great. Phobiaverse, lots of people spent lots of money to keep them in the public.
Just for the sake of rocket bullets.
That's exactly right. Hey, who doesn't love rocket bullets?
Because if there's two orgasmic words to a gun nut, rocket bullets.
Hey, all right. Shooting it with your dirty...
Yeah, my pistol has a longer range than the shotgun. So
that's true.
That's why I have it. That's why I'm using it. My revolver has a nice long barrel. One down.
It just happens to be Spider 8.
He's on Avertus. I need to move him from Avertus.
Spider 5 is on Avertus too.
Damn these spiders.
Cheeky bastards.
They are cheeky bastards.
Yay!
I love seeing the word stabilization failure.
You know, it's a good thing.
I'm not going to say anything because I don't want to be someone looking at that when it's me.
We'll enjoy it. No.
No, enjoy it for me. All right. Thanks, guys.
So,
what was it when that character fails their last death save? Oh no! Anyway.
So Spider, okay. Spider number 5 charges at the vehicle, leaps up onto the hood.
Oh damn! No es bueno.
No es bueno. Triage. You have a guest.
It's like a girl. And I double tap that spider.
Glad he didn't go for the grenade.
No, that'd be really bad. I have a thermite grenade loaded right now.
Oh yeah, no.
When you're
playing
with me, when you're playing with fire.
We are not messing around this time around.
You guys leveled up. Last time you know what I mean? It's like going back into like the older areas of like a Final Fantasy game. You're like, these goblins ain't shit.
The Zogre over here, though. Fun.
Okay. I got fired 2 bullets. Awesome.
Nice. It just sort of collapses, and its legs are twitching.
I spend my move action to shudder.
Now the big question is, does Big Mama come out after we killed her babies?
Well, that's a very good question.
Like Triage, you want to load some fire?
Already got some.
Your turn.
Oh boy.
Yep, your turn, but from your point of view or your vantage point, I don't know that you can see anything other than the dying number 8 and the dying number 5.
You definitely cannot.
So you can always...
Just going to ready in action. Ready to shoot the first moving, living spider that I see.
Living and not living.
Then we have a whole new problem on this island. And I don't want to think about it.
This campaign went really weird.
After all the awful
more
things
than
we've
it already
done.
Is.
Oh no. I just thought of a better plan. We go out of here without killing the giant spider. We put up a whole bunch of signs saying, Black Gauntlet, we're in here. And we like hide in a tree with binoculars and giggle.
Both like school children.
Yep. Alright, I have ready to action. I'm assuming we're going to pull up.
I'll do the same. I'll ready in action to shoot something with my revolver. whatever spider comes around the corner.
Okay, so you guys are going to pull up some. How far up would you like to move? Go ahead.
No, we're not moving.
Okay, you're just...
I'm ready.
Okay.
We're going to sit there, yeah. They move very quickly, so it gives us time to shoot them.
Okay.
Yeah. Well, that looks like some triggered help actions.
Yeah, just a couple.
And here we go, triage.
Triage didn't ready in action, so
okay. Gamble, so
gamble first.
Yep.
Oh yeah.
Like, there's the cheeky bastards.
Fire your gyrus at a jet assault rifle.
Ooh. All right, dead hand. Dead hand.
It's because the other one's on the hood. I can't quite see.
Use your move action and push him off with the butt of your shotgun.
All right, sure. I'll move my move action to grab the leg. And... Damn, I didn't know it was that good.
Nah, you guys are missing.
We're just underneath.
We're in cover.
Oh, fantasy grounds.
Well, you know, let's just be real. I don't know that I'm using tokens in the proper way. Just because I can doesn't mean I should. You know how computers do things.
Proper shopper. I don't know.
Yeah.
Triage. I do believe it is your turn, however. And you were lining up a shot.
I'm auto-firing.
Okay.
So, straight auto fire, I need to hit a 10, I believe. And it gets to make a reflex save at DC 15. It fails. Oh man, I barely succeed. It takes damage.
Nice.
And that leaves my weapon empty, so I reload my rifle, brand new magazine.
Okay.
And that's my turn.
All right, Gamble.
All right. The real question is, do we want to move up now, or do we want to keep readying actions for spiders we can't see?
I think we can ready another round of actions. I'm cool with that.
All right, yeah.
You see how fast they move?
Yep.
I get the feeling.
I
don't want to get bit.
Turn around and then back towards the tunnel, and if something comes out at us, we can drive away while I shoot at it.
Do we have enough space to turn a Humvee around in this tunnel?
Have you seen Austin Powers?
I'll just reverse if it's all the same.
Yeah, that works.
It has a reverse gear. I can reverse.
Okay. All right. Anyway,
so I'm going to hold your action until you see something to kill for this round. Correct, Gamble?
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Dead hand.
Same thing.
Are you not driving?
No, nope.
I am driving, but I'm staying still. Again, I'm not getting closer. We're waiting to see what else comes across that corner. They move too quickly. I don't want to get bit again. Shit sucked.
Next round. Nothing ended up happening during that moment. Those moments. We are at the top of round 3 with triage.
I say. Oh god, that scared the crap out of me.
Yeah, hold on. Yes. Spider.
I say, stay here. I'm going to scout ahead, staying hidden.
He says he walks directly towards... This is like the same situation, but reversed.
It would totally make more sense for you to stay on the big gun and for Gambolt. Okay.
I do better with my rifle. Way better. So I need to make a move silently check. And I'm going to spend a second move action to continue moving.
Don't touch the webs this time, Triage.
I can't move that far yet.
Gimbal's just saying that for encouragement. Don't touch the webs this time.
Okay. that's my turn.
You guys are using night vision goggles, using flashlights, candles.
I think we were on night vision.
Yeah.
And I'm guessing it's still completely pitch black in here.
Yes, that is correct. It's still completely pitch black in here.
Unless this is like Skyrim and you have magical torches.
Yeah, they're called night vision goggles.
Dwemer torches have been placed. All right, so we have Gamble's turn, right?
Yep. Okay. So, let me do the move silently check here, and I'm going to move up the other side of the tunnel.
Nice.
As soon as I find move silently, there it is. There you go. And I'm just going to use both my move actions to line up with old Triage there.
Alrighty.
And okay. Click again. Okay. Alright. And boom.
Mr. Deadhand, now there, y'all fellas now have just left a vehicle now.
I'm going to ready in action to move up and pick these guys up if something comes around that corner that I can't handle.
Great idea.
Alright, so the car's just sitting there idling.
Yeah.
Ready to go into drive and save the day. Okay. All right now.
Dead.
Which way this thing skipped its turn?
Ruh-roh.
I'm gonna say it was here because it saw you from the corner. And it can't quite get to the other guy. It did use its full move though.
Great.
It could do, what is a bull rush? It is a full move action, right?
I believe it requires a charge, which means it needs to move in a straight line.
Which is not exactly the situation here, so. No. I was trying to go for a bull rush fork towards Gamble, but that's just not going to happen today.
I think a bull rush is about pushing someone.
I'm not just a bull rush, there's a charge attack, I mean.
Oh, yeah.
The charge attack. I'll look that up in some other time. Like, in 5 minutes. So, this thing's dying.
Cool.
Oh, stable success.
Wow,
that's rare.
Once the medic spider comes around, heal. Right.
5 foot step. There's my move action.
Okay.
And once I have done that, the attack.
It gets a.
It gets a.
Nothing. I was gonna say, I was gonna suggest that it gets an attack of opportunity on you.
But 5 foot steps don't provoke that.
Mm-hmm. And that's why I stopped.
Yep.
Und then double tap.
I've asked the question enough about fucking 5 foot about attacks of opportunity. I finally learned.
Uh oh.
Spider number 20.
That's my turn.
All All right.
Gamble, okay. To your right, you just saw this medium-sized spider just leap over the concrete 5-foot wall there and come.
I cannot change my facing.
It's a twist.
We're just.
Can you not twist?
Nope, not with those tokens locked.
I can. Tell me where. Okay. Apparently, so
I turn to look at the spider.
This or this? This.
That'll work. Yeah. There's no direct looking at it. So. Yeah. All right, and with Gyrojet in hand, schwunk! Oh, son of a bitch. That's what I get for making the sound effect.
Hey, at least you didn't shoot me.
It like bounces off the lower wall, and it still has like enough ignition to like sort of spiral up into the air, and then it has like, it just sort of like fizzles out, and then the slug falls to the ground.
Man, I was having such a good run too. Like I hit things like twice in a row. Around. Oh God, no. All right.
Yep. Oh yeah.
Oh God. All right. Well.
Yeah. Here we are now.
That triggers. I'm guessing that triggers.
That triggers a dead hand rolling the fucking car up real quick.
I mean, is it? Are they in trouble? I mean, I don't know that they're in trouble.
This sounds
I am telling you that was what I was looking for.
Were you? Because you didn't say that at all. I didn't.
I said if they come into something I know they can't handle, i.e. the big spider.
You really don't have confidence in your teammates, and I don't think that's really fair.
He did just watch Gamble.
I have confidence that they will kill things. I just don't have confidence that they'll survive.
And besides, he just watched Gamble fail to hit a spider with a rocket bullet from 15 feet away.
Deadhand, go ahead. And you are going to drive your vehicle into this gargantuan spider as an attack action? Is that what I'm under to understand?
Sure.
Let's do it. Fuck it.
Assert dominance with giants. This is American engineering.
I mean, otherwise, you did say that you would pull up and just like, you know, casually pull up like an Uber and be like, "Excuse me, hey, I'm in a tan Hummer here for an Uber."
I could totally do that.
I mean, I'm just giving you options here.
That's a wonderful option. File that under Plan D or F or something.
Plan U for E, U for
Uber. Yeah, plan U for
Uber. That means but L no, gets a better chance.
I'll drive into it.
Okay. So, let's see. So, Joel.
You need that handy chart.
Yeah. What do we think is the speed that this thing can...
In that short distance?
In 50 feet, yeah.
You got that... chart handy?
I am pulling up. Uno momento, por favor. And it will be shared in the convo.
Thank you. There it is. All right. Speed category. He can easily get to cautious. Maybe with a drive check, he could get up to cruising.
Okay. Give me a drive check, Mr. Deadhand.
For sure. With an action point, in fact.
Nice.
I'll even use an action point for this. Okay. Didn't even roll. All right. Thanks, Dice.
No,
right.
I rolled a 2.
Yeah, well, I mean, what I mean is that like I threw it, but it just fell over.
Seems legit.
That one didn't even do anything.
On the... brakes.
Plus 2. 18.
Oh, yeah, plus 2. Yeah.
18.
Okay, 18's not bad.
Yeah. I go with that. That's not bad. I mean, you're just driving forward really fast, and it doesn't take a genius.
Though I am one.
Vehicle size is
would
huge.
Would you like to take a move action? No. Would you like to take a standard action to put your seatbelt on? Because I don't remember you putting on a seatbelt at any point during this.
If you're offering it, yes.
I mean, I'm just putting it out there, I'm asking.
Yeah, sure.
You know, I mean, I could be a jerk.
JC said yes, go.
I like my brain matter where it is, so yes, that's a great idea.
Fly through the windshield and then discover that you're sitting on it?
I could get a lot of flack for even suggesting that you play smarter. So, anyway. The cruising... All right, so go ahead. All right, great. We're gonna, I like to give people crap. It's what I do.
I know. We're good.
Bam! Okay.
So we're going to bump into this thing here. While you are, boom, in the car, driver's seat, and you're gonna go ahead and how do I want to do this? This is an attack roll, but yeah, just give me an attack roll, like a melee.
Check.
Yeah. Give me a melee. Check. It's a melee. Because you're on top of it. You're just you're meleeing it with your vehicle. So give me a melee attack.
Fair enough. Hey.
And I want to see what stat I would throw at that off of the Hummer thing here. If there's anything here worth looking at.
Is D8 damage.
Mm-hmm.
What size is the Hummer?
It's just a
huge, I think.
Yeah.
It's a gargantuan.
No, it's not gargantuan. I'm pretty sure it's huge.
All right. Let me pull up my PDF to find that again, because we used that. Ah, here we go. Number of dice. The smallest object is huge, so it's 12d8 damage. Yes.
All right,
we're gonna fuck this Hummer up.
To both the Hummer and the spider.
So 12d8.
Yes.
I'm gonna do 10 and then 6. Is that cool?
That makes not 12.
All right, 10. Yeah, 10 d6 and then 2d6.
No. 12d8.
Oh, 8. Even better. I like that. Okay. I'm gonna roll 10 of these to that. That didn't do anything. Thanks, dice.
Yeah.
How do I roll damage onto this guy?
I think you gotta just roll it and then Jace has to do it automatically. Yeah, there you go.
Alright, so that's and then I need two more. Nope, that's 3. Stop adding.
I'll do the math.
I got a calculator. Hold on a second.
57.
Okay.
Yeah, there you go.
So it's 57 damage to the spider and 57 damage to the Hummer.
57 damage also to the Hummer.
The Hummer has a hardness of 5, so it's only 52.
Oh, only 52. Okay.
Then Hummer doesn't have that much hit points.
I know. So, it doesn't matter. I don't give a shit. It's not my Hummer.
The vehicle has been totaled. There has to be crash damage to the occupant, but he gets 3/4 something. Check that while I'm doing some spider stuff.
What?
How much does
he get hurt? Like, how much? Because the vehicle's totaled. And not just totaled. It's like beyond totaled.
Oh, sorry. There's a multiplier on that.
Oh, God.
Head-on collision to a creature is a x2.
Oh.
So that's to the creature.
Yeah.
So
114.
And then to the driver.
You guys said it's 114.
Hold on, yeah, hold on. To the spider. 114 to the spider. Yeah. If there's that multiplier thing is accurate.
The spider squishes underneath as yes. as the front grill of this heavy Hummer just rams into it. And as the front grill like starts to fold in on the engine, sort of collapse in on itself, it's also just sort of jamming its metal bits into the back of this spider and its face as it just completely crushes it. So the only thing sticking out underneath is actually like the spider's the thorax. The rear thorax, and its like legs are like squiggling around in a spasmodic fashion, and it's making this ungodly like squealing sort of sound, and just really high pitched shrill, and it's just there's just this ooze, this just black sort of just ooze is just sort of filling up the area surrounding it there. And Deadhand, what happens to you, my friend?
I don't know.
I'm really hoping we didn't just kill that end.
I did tell him to wear his seatbelt.
Yeah, you did, and that should help.
I also offered him to do the Uber.
Over. Yeah, no, you did. I'm not saying you didn't.
No, if we kill Deadhead, it's entirely our own fault. But I'm just hoping.
Oh, I know. I'm just saying. That I like to give everyone lots of options.
I mean, at least we killed the spider. So if Deadhand does die, at least he took out a giant spider with him.
You guys gonna have to like radio back to base, like that to the ship, and be like, "We need another operative."
Do you have another Deadhand?
We're gonna need another electronic specialist.
We're gonna need another Timmy.
Will Deadhand survive his encounter with the gargantuan spider? Tune in next time on Isle Noir.